Hi students, in today's session I am going to discuss trick to balance disproportionation reactions with 5 simple steps. This topic is from redox reactions chapter. In this video I am going to discuss both in acidic medium how you can balance as well as in basic medium also with this 5 simple steps. Let me show you the 5 simple steps. Step number 1. Find oxidation number. Whatever the reaction is there, find the oxidation number of each element. For example, 0 here, plus 1, minus 1. If you don't know how to find oxidation number, I already uploaded 2 videos, 2 best videos. Please go through that. And after finding oxidation number, identify which element is undergoing oxidation and which one is undergoing reduction. Once you identify which is undergoing oxidation, which is undergoing reduction, separate both the reactions, oxidation reaction separately as well as reduction reaction separately. Step number 3. Balance number of atoms other than oxygen and hydrogen. So once you balance the number of atoms, don't balance oxygen and hydrogen. After balancing number of atoms, just balance the number of electrons change. Few they do like charge balancing, you can do in this way also electron balancing you do. In previous video, one video I did there, many students asked me regarding charge balancing. I do in this way. You can balance in the form of electrons. It will be easy. Then after balancing the number of electrons, then you can balance oxygen and hydrogen. To balance oxygen, just you put water molecule. For one oxygen, you put one water molecule, and to balance hydrogen, you put H plus ions in the opposite direction. That's it. Once two reactions you balance separately, add both the reactions. Before adding, just see whether the number of electrons in both the reactions are same or not. If number of electrons in both the reactions are not same, then multiply with a suitable number so that the number of electrons will become same. After that, just add both the reactions, then you will get a balanced reaction. I'll show you how you can do it. Cl2 plus OH minus, here I am taking basic medium, but I will show you in acidic, after that basic. Okay, here I whatever this steps is for acidic medium. In this session only I will discuss basic medium. What I taught you, step number 1, find oxidation number. After that, just identify which is undergoing oxidation. 0 to plus 1. Change in, increase in oxidation number. Oxidation number is increased from 0 to plus 1. So it is oxidation. Oxidation is loss of electrons, right? Here Cl2 is changed from 0 to minus 1. So 0 to minus 1. 0 to plus 1. 0 to minus 1. Here increased oxidation number, so it is oxidation. And 0 to minus 1, decrease in oxidation number is reduction. How an oxidation number will be increased? By loss of electrons. And how an oxidation number is decreased? By gain of electrons, right? See here, this is reduction. And if you observe, chlorine is undergoing both oxidation as well as a reduction. The element which is undergoing both oxidation and reduction in a particular chemical reaction, that particular reaction we call it as disproportionation reaction. What is disproportionation reaction? The reaction in which What is disproportionation reaction, students? The reaction in which same element is undergoing both oxidation as well as reduction. Those reactions are called disproportionation reactions. Then here, after doing the first and second steps, what you should do? What is the second step? You have to separate both the oxidation and reduction reactions. Which is oxidation reaction? This one. Cl2 is converted into ClO minus. What is the reduction reaction? Cl2 is converted into Cl minus. Next, what you have to do? You have to balance number of atoms. Second step, this is third step. Number of atoms here 2, here 1. So put 2 before this, and here Cl2, just put 2 before this. After that, what you should do? Here itself you balance number of electrons. balance carefully. Few they feel difficulty while balancing the charge. So balance in the form of electrons, then it will be easy. Both are same actually. Cl2, what is the oxidation state? 0. But it is changed to plus 1. So what is the change from 0 to plus 1? What is the difference is 1. Okay. 1 chlorine change is 1. How many chlorine atoms are there? Students, 2. So change is 2. Change is 2 means 2 electrons. The 2 electrons in which side you have to add? This is oxidation. Oxidation means loss of electrons. So you have to add. This is oxidation, right? So I am adding here. After that, you have to balance what number of other atoms, oxygen and hydrogen. How many oxygens are there? 2. Here actually 1, right? 1 into 2, 2 oxygens. For 1 oxygen, you should put 1 water molecule. And for 2 oxygens, you should put 2 water molecules. So, plus 2H2O gives rise to 2ClO minus plus 2 electrons. Now, oxygen is balanced. You have to balance hydrogens. 2 into 2. 4 hydrogens are there. So you have to put H plus ions. In which direction actually? In which direction H plus ions are less? So H plus ions are less in which direction? Right hand side. So I'll put here 4 H plus ions. Now everything is balanced. If you still get doubt that charge is balanced or not, you can check. Here any charge is there on molecule? No charge. 0 charge here. No charge. Here minus 2. And here 2 into minus 1, minus 2, minus 2. And 4 into plus 1, plus 4. So plus 4, minus 4, 0. Here also no charge. Clear? So you balance charge also. So better to do here itself in the form of electrons. That will be very easy. Coming to this, which reaction this is, students? This is reduction reaction. We already balanced number of atoms. Now balance the number of electrons. Here change is from 0 to minus 1. What is the difference? 1. Here 1 chlorine is gaining 1 electron. Why I am telling gaining? Because it is a reduction reaction. For 2 chlorine atoms, 2 electrons. Next, no oxygen, no hydrogen. So it is already balanced. Take this equation for example as equation 1. This is equation 2. If number of electrons are not same in both the cases, then multiply with a number so that the number of electrons will be same. Here already both are same, so directly I will add both the reactions. Now I will write both the reactions here one more time. Cl2 plus 2H2O gives rise to 2ClO minus plus 2 electrons plus 4H plus. Clear? This again I will write Cl2 plus 2 electrons gives rise to 2Cl minus. What you can cancel here? Number of electrons. Anything is similar? No. So add the reaction. Add both the reactions. 2Cl2 plus 2H2O gives rise to 2Cl minus plus 2ClO minus plus what is left? 4H plus. Now, here, if you observe, you can cancel not 2, simple ratio you can take. 2 1s are, 2 1s are, 2 1s are, 2 1s are, 2 2s are. So, what is the ultimate reaction we got? I will write here, see. What we got? Cl2 plus H2O gives rise to Cl minus plus ClO minus plus 2H plus. Right? This is in acidic medium. Acidic medium. Now convert this into basic medium. How to do in basic medium? Always better to follow the same steps because it will be very easy. Now this only I am converting into basic medium. Then it is easy. No confusion like which side we have to add OH minus. For water how many OH minus. All these confusions you can avoid easily. How many H plus ions are there? Add same number of OH minus ions, students. Here 2 H plus ions are there. So add 2 OH minus ions. At the same time opposite side also add 2 OH minus. This is step number 1 for basic medium. 2 OH minus this side. Why I am adding only 2? Because here 2 H plus is there. And opposite side also 2 OH minus I am adding. Clear? After that step number 2 is add these 2. H plus and OH. 1 H plus, 1 OH minus, 1 H2O. 2 H plus plus 2 OH minus, 2 H2O. So here 2 H2O is there, here 1 H2O is there. Cancel it. 2 and here 2, here 1. So 1 will be left. Now write the reaction. Cl2 plus 2 OH minus gives rise to Cl minus plus ClO minus plus H2O. Right? Now let me show you whether it is correct or not. This is an NCERT textbook. See, this is a concept under disproportionation reactions. Cl2 plus 2 OH minus gives rise to Cl minus plus ClO minus plus H2O. Clear? Now I am going to give the test yourself question, this one. Don't see the answer. Just you try this example. After doing this, what you have to do is just take the ratio. In JE and all, the question will be asked like, what is the ratio of S2 minus by S2O3 minus 2. Integer type of question. You have to find. For example, this is 6, this is 2. Then the ratio is 3 is your answer. Try this question and comment me your answer. After that, whenever you get the free time, almost 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 examples are there. We finished how many? 2, remaining 3 you can try. If you found this video helpful, please click on like. My name is Komali. I'm your chemistry mentor. Thanks for watching. Your love and support so precious to me. To express, please hit on like.